Strike first, strike hard, and no mercy. A new Cobra Kai is in town. Yes, Cobra Kai is finally upon us on YouTube Red. I entered into a 30-day free trial, and I have to say, this surprised me and was much better than it actually should have been. If you're a fan of the Karate Kid films, more specifically, the Dan LaRusso trilogy and the original 1984 film, then you will highly enjoy this. This is probably my favorite follow-up to a property over 30 years old since Creed. It really is good. It not only brings something that's fresh and original, but it also honors the legacy of the original films. I love this, but it brings a different perspective with Johnny Lawrence. William Zabka reprises his role. And you could say he was kind of like the prototype bully of the 1980s, but here, it's much more complex. There is no clear protagonist or antagonist. There is no black versus white. It really is more of like real life. They each have their good moments, they each have their bad moments. Dan LaRusso is also in this, reprised by Ralph Macchio. And it's great that we see these two characters at this point in their lives. It actually is a true follow-up. Where will they be now? And Daniel and Johnny have kind of inversed in their life. Johnny's not well off, and Dan LaRusso has a family and is very rich. He's pretty much like Johnny's family when he was younger, and Johnny's kind of like in Daniel's predicament when he was younger, so it's interesting seeing that. Johnny is also kind of like a Miyagi figure to this new character called Miguel. He's the next Karate Kid in this series that joins Cobra Kai that helps Johnny in his way, and I love this. Johnny goes through a lesson in this whole first season, and he not only helps these group of children and Miguel, but they help him in return. Such a great series that has a lot of heart, action, a great story with that right amount of 80s charm. There's so many nods to the original films that it doesn't feel like it's just done as fan service. It actually fits the story and is done very well in good taste. I love this show. We pick up with Johnny. We get to see unused footage of the Karate Kid, and he's just in the dumps, having like the worst time of his life. He's stuck in the 80s, watching Iron Eagle, and eventually he sees Miguel, this kid at his apartment, being bullied by these group of kids. He comes to his defense, and through the course of the show, he ends up teaching Miguel karate and opening up Cobra Kai. We also get to see Dan LaRusso. Again, like I said earlier, he has a family. He has a son who's kind of into video games and doesn't want to talk to his father. And then he has this daughter named Samantha, who's kind of getting into the wrong clique of girls. But he also has a wife. I love it. I love the family dynamic of the show. I like the relationship with Dale and his wife, Amanda. I also like that he owns a car dealership. We get to see nods to that, the bonsai tree. And there's also some slight nods to Mr. Miyagi. And those are just some heartfelt moments. This show is amazing. I have to say, it really surprised me. And I like the character dynamics. I also like that it's not trying to be politically correct in this time of 2018. Johnny is a bit extreme, using the term of like immigrants and illegal to Miguel at the beginning, but ultimately, he's just a guy who does not take any shit from anybody. He calls out all the bullshit of this modern generation. I love it. I love it. Johnny truly is a character that's trapped in the 80s onto this world, and it would not have worked if they watered down his character. No. But he is a person with a good heart. He's very flawed. And it brings up an interesting dynamic of the Karate Kid. We now get to see things through Johnny's point of view. And that is something that's game-changing, because you can watch The Karate Kid and you sympathize with Dan LaRusso, yet once you see things through Johnny Lawrence's point of view, it really starts to shift the perspective of who's the hero and villain of this story. And again, there really is no clear hero and villain. They kind of both are. They're both similar, yet different. Both same, but different. And I love that dynamic of the show. And the trailer made it look like it was going to be half of a fan film and half of like a real movie. This is actually really well done. This is almost like a 5-hour movie of The Karate Kid, a true sequel, a true follow-up to the original. And it's just interesting seeing the actions of each character, the consequences of everything from the original film and what it has done to their lives, both of them, at this point. I love this show. I would give it a 4.5 out of 5. But you know what? Hey-ya! We're gonna crush that to 5 out of 5. This is an awesome show. I needed this. In this world of darkness, we needed this ray of light called Cobra Kai. We needed this to come back, and it is better than ever. Johnny also makes Cobra Kai that's different from Kreese, his former master, his former sensei. But you get to see Johnny go through a hero's journey in a way. You get to see him go through an arc. And Daniel as well. Daniel kind of got away from his roots. He's kind of become a dick towards Johnny. We get to see him come closer to his roots. We also get to see Johnny as an estranged father, and that relationship is very interesting. Ultimately, the relationship between the original characters and the next generation of characters is very interesting. It's a powerful dynamic of the show, and Johnny and his relationship with Miguel is ultimately the heart of this, as well as Daniel and learning from Mr. Miyagi in the past and moving on without him. Such a great show. If it wasn't for the original actors, I don't know if it would have been this good, but it does honor the legacy, it does feel authentic, and it does everything that a lot of reboots are missing now. It not only brings a refreshing and original take, but it also honors what came before and carries on that legacy, and that's what a lot of reboots are missing these days. And Cobra Kai is nothing short of phenomenal. I love it. So yes, a 5 out of 5. If you're a fan of the Karate Kid films, definitely check out Cobra Kai. You will not regret it. It has some amazing dramatic moments, action, heart, some 80s charm with montages. I love it. Definitely check it out. You can also follow me on the Stardust app. I have my reactions, and you can post your reactions and reviews on the Stardust app. Follow me at Fred Film Fanatic. Like, comment on what you thought of Cobra Kai, and subscribe for more videos. Spoilers. That ending was insane, with Kreese being alive and coming back and telling Johnny, "You did what I always knew you could do. Win." And it was ballsy for Johnny's dojo of Cobra Kai to win the All Valley tournament. In a way, it was winning without really winning for Johnny. He still had a strained relationship with his son, who now sees Daniel LaRusso as a father figure. And he now sees the attitude of the kids change and become very much like the Cobra Kai he was a part of in Kreese's day and age. And that was brilliant because it really wasn't a clear win. There's still more to be explored, and as Kreese said, the story has just begun, and I love that. I love the relationship between Miguel and Sam. That was done very well. The young hearts moment, I love that moment. And it was tragic what happened to them on the fight on the beach with Johnny's son. And ultimately, the story was just so strong. The young characters were done very well, the bully culture. I like Johnny when Aisha joined. That was a great part. Aisha is a good character, and I love it where she tells him that she's been cyberbullied, and he's just like, oh my god. And you think he's gonna like sympathize with her. He's like, such pussies, man. Back in my day, we would have said that shit to your face. And I love that just bluntness and just straightforwardness of Johnny and his character. That's so much of Johnny, him not associating with these kids. But we learn more about Johnny and his past, and he may have not been as different to Daniel or these new kids in his dojo. And that's such a powerful statement. Above all, despite the extremisms and cruelty, it really is him teaching these kids to stand up for themselves. And there's a strong theme in that. No matter how the methods are with Cobra Kai and Miyagi-Do, it really is a strong lesson of teaching these kids, hey, you need to learn how to stand up for yourselves and not take any shit from anybody in the real world. And in a way, they teach Johnny a valuable lesson about himself and moving forward with his life. Superb show. This needs a season 2. Check it out on YouTube Red. I've watched it like twice now. I love this show. Anyway, that's it for this video. Like, comment, subscribe, check out the Stardust app, and also stay tuned for later in the month. I'm going to have a Godzilla 20th anniversary retrospective. Wax on, wax off. Hyah!